You're still here. Fantastic. I know you want to get to the juicy bits, but I need to bother you once again with a bunch of general advice so you don't shoot yourself in the foot. Not all tools are created equal, and like you learned in the quiz, not all optimizations are worth doing. Let's go through a few common scenarios that set you up for failure. Chances are you probably can't. And even if you can, it won't be worth it. To give you a web dev example, hundreds of engineering years went into tiny JS libraries like jQuery, including some of my time actually, and yet countless developers have tried to replicate it with a 90% similar feature set, only to fail hard again and again. Even popular clones like Zepto couldn't keep up when they realized that jQuery fixed a lot more cross-browser madness than people thought, even in modern browsers. Now we're talking idealistic versus pragmatic. Yes, that 20% speed increase would be ideal, but sticking to a tool that is well supported by the community is pragmatic. Gulp might be a little slower than someone else's new tool, but you'll find answers for your questions on Stack Overflow, plugins for virtually anything, and can rest assured that the tool is going to be maintained by its creators. Don't just trust your instincts, but consider the long-term value for your project. So it's neatly contained, all in one package, huh? Well, be careful with those. If a tool promises to do it all and stays away from offering any sort of connection point, say an API or modules, run. No, seriously. Life is too short to buy into an ecosystem that you can't escape from, especially if the success of your site depends on it. And finally, you should be careful with any micro-optimizations that are just not worth it. If you're doing an optimization of your workflow that takes, say, 4 hours, and cuts a second away from a task you perform once during the day, you need to do it for 40 years to justify the investment. And in 40 years, you could be sitting in an intergalactic flying car, exploring the outer realms of space instead.